Helicopter seats are a little more complicated than you may think. Not only are we designing it for comfort and usability, but also for crashworthiness and safety. Now, to do that, we have to use seat attenuators. So, what are seat attenuators? Well, seat attenuators absorb the energy from a vertical impact. And in this scenario that we're going to be going down to a crash center today, we're going to be testing for a 30G vertical impact. And the entire point of this is to keep what would be the human spine in the seat at a constant 20G as the seat attenuator absorbs the energy at a constant rate.
So our first configuration was a single tube, where the tube is kind of mounted on the seat, center line of the seat, behind the passenger. And so when the seat goes into its 30G drop, this is compressed and crushed behind the passenger's back. So basically we worked up a fairly simple spreadsheet to calculate the energy absorption for a given thickness of laminate. And we had the material supplier's energy joules per gram number to start with. So we worked at just basically sizing using the manufacturer's data. We then produced some test tubes and we went to a test house and did what in effect is the same as what we're going to do with the dynamic test, but we did it as a quasi-static, which means we just crushed at a controlled rate and measured the energy absorption for a given displacement. The energy under the curve, force displacement curve, gives you the energy. And from that, we could then clarify exactly what the joules per gram consumed was, which was very close to the manufacturer's number, but not quite as good, which is not surprising. And then we recalibrated our tubes, now having a hard number for the joules per gram. And so these tubes are being sized with that information gleaned from the first set of quasi-static tests. So now the next step is to go and do a dynamic test to sign them off. So if these behave as planned, we get a lovely sort of flat force displacement curve sitting nicely at 20G, then we'll be very happy. That'd be ideal. But we're still testing, so you know, even if it's a little bit high or a bit low, we can adjust that by just tuning the wall thickness of the tube, basically. Carbon crush tubes are used in Formula One for side impact absorption. So yes, the technology has been used elsewhere, but I don't think it's been used in this particular application before.
So is this something actually tested in your Formula One days?
Yes. A lot of smashing of carbon in my days. So.
Thank you.
So that's why we're going down to Cranfield Impact Centre today to test our seat attenuators.
Pretty good though.
And there we have it. The results for the seat attenuators test are in, and they're better than expected. So it's safe to say that Tim's a very happy chap at the moment. So if you enjoyed this video, be sure to like and subscribe. And until next time,